Jones Broadcasting Network. Network.
Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Folks, final segment with Stefan Molyneux, our guest here, talking about the future of the world, our current state. We're done with calls now in the 5 minutes we've got here. I want to thank you for coming in, spending time with us, Stefan. Getting into the war on males briefly, but first, you wanted to make a point.
Yeah, I just really wanted to tell people that the government's escalation of its power is absolutely not going to stop until we stop it. Right? It is going to continue to grow. It is like somebody wildly addicted to some substance. They need an intervention. In a weird kind of way, you can do it out of love for the people on the other side of the gun. You know, take the gun away from them gently because it's not good for them. Like that great scene in the DeBrando movie on the waterfront where he takes that gun away from his brother gently and tenderly who's there to kill him and all. And we just have to take this power away from people. It's bad for them. It's toxic for society as a whole. They're addicts. You know, what do you do with somebody who's addicted? You try and take that substance away from them so that they can get their heads clear. It's not going to stop. There's nothing.
And I've noticed with narcissism, power addiction isn't just in government. Either people are getting more enlightened or they're going on weird power trips.
Yeah.
And like saying, I'm invincible. You're going to do what I say.
Yeah. I'm right because I'm me. And it, you know, we have to, you know, whether it's lovingly or assertively or even aggressively, we have to just take away this power from these people. It is so destructive to humanity as a whole, and they can't do it themselves. The only people who get that kind of power are people who are addicted and want more of it no matter what.
I know some of your views on this, but our current issue of the magazine is all about the chemicals, the food, the water, the culture, every TV show, bad-mouthing fathers, men.
Yeah.
What is the war on men about? I guess the state wants to be the daddy now?
Yeah, I mean, the more that the government can break the bonds between men and women, the more that they can make women dependent on the state and guarantee future votes from them and their children.
And Bernays wrote books on that, and it's public policy.
And this has been a Marxist, leftist, progressive policy for hundreds of years.
They've done a great job with the family courts and everything.
Oh, yeah. I mean, more money flows through the family courts and all the other courts put together. The average divorce costs $50,000. And in other areas of the world, like in some of the Scandinavian countries, you just write something in and send it off and you're divorced in 6 months. And the no-fault divorce. Divorce used to be a contract, the most serious contract in the world, much more important than your cell phone contract, which you can't break. It was Reagan in the 60s in California brought in the no-fault divorce. You used to actually prove, you had to prove abuse or infidelity to get divorced before. And now you can just get divorced because you want to. Majority of divorces, 60-70%, initiated by women for dissatisfaction, for reasons of dissatisfaction.
And it's advertised as the really cool thing to do. The truth is, statistically, it's literally turning us into animals.
Oh,
it's destroying the human unit, and the children are now the wards of the state, and the women are the tarts of the state.
Yeah, and so basically, the government is now stepped into the provider role that used to be inhabited by the male, and therefore the women have now changed their allegiance towards statism, which is why more women vote Democrat and why there's good statistical studies that show that the increase in state power accelerated significantly after giving women the vote. Again, not that giving the women the vote is bad or anything, but the inevitable result.
It was Eva Bernays. They said, have our feminists smoke cigarettes, the women will smoke them.
Yeah.
I mean, they just have been preying on women.
Yeah.
And statistically, women on every metric are going to hell in a handbasket. And so are their sons and daughters, and so are the men.
Well, it's so
devastating victory for the New World Order.
And incredibly destructive. You know, there's no single worse predictor of a negative outcome for a child than becoming from a single mother household or a single parent household. It's worse than race. It's worse than gender. It's worse than demography. It's worse than socioeconomic status.
But they advertise it in all the women's magazines and shows as like a new set of clothes. It is the sexy, cool thing to do.
Yeah, and it is incredibly destructive for children. It's one thing to get divorced.
And it is liberating to sit out and go and do whatever you want.
Yeah,
but you had kids, and now statistically, it's going to wreck their life.
And now we have to pay.
But you don't care because you're a state-run Jezebel.
Yeah, and we have to pay the price for them becoming criminals. It's everyone else who suffers when these kids get out into society.
Blacks had 10% illegitimacy before the Great Society. It's now 90%.
Yeah,
and whites are right online to the same deal. Totally wrecked. just running around, completely collapsed. End of civilization.
Yeah. Growth of the state is the end of the family, and vice versa.
But it's trendy. Yeah. But it's trendy.
Strength of the family.
Oh, yeah.
One of Jones here to tell you about how you can help spread liberty worldwide while also enjoying what I have found to be the best tasting 100% organic coffee on the planet. For more than a decade, my favorite coffee has come from the high mountains of southern Mexico, where the Chiapas farmers grow their unique shade-grown Arabica beans. We have now managed to secure these sought-after beans in a highly custom out of the water supply yet, but we can help to get it out of our bodies. I am extremely excited to announce the